Search engines are your gateway to the sites you visit every day. They act as a middleman, allowing us to search for what we want and connecting us to what we're looking for. But because of their ability to view everything we do, they have become some of the world's largest data collectors, including Google, Microsoft through Bing, and Yahoo. These are all very non-privacy oriented companies, and even if you don't have an account with them, they are still building a profile on your searches for commercial purposes. Obviously, this is a big privacy concern. We can't have people knowing everything we're searching for and tying that to our personal information. Because of this, we need to find search engines that collect as little information as possible. Luckily, there are three very good options, which we will discuss today, each with their own pros and cons. One of the cons to the free version of this course is the promos, so here we go. Thanks to everyone watching the free version of Go Incognito. If you're enjoying the course and want to support everything it stands for, please consider becoming a patron at patreon.com/techlore. Not only are there awesome benefits like monthly one-on-one support, but you're also becoming a crucial part of how this course is maintained and updated in the future. Thank you, lemurs, and enjoy the lesson. The very first service is DuckDuckGo, which is probably the most popular and widely used privacy search engine. Some of the nice things about DuckDuckGo is they have a beautiful UI, in my opinion. They are privacy oriented and extremely public about the information they collect about you. In addition, they let you use tags to instantly search different search engines, and they offer an onion variant to be used inside of Tor. Some problems are they are based in the United States, sparking jurisdiction concerns, and the core of the service uses proprietary software. There are additional concerns with DuckDuckGo being a company that relies on Amazon to deliver their service, since this could be a potential avenue of attack from intelligence bureaus looking to track DuckDuckGo users. Because of privacy concerns, I wouldn't say DuckDuckGo is our best bet, although it's still infinitely better than Google, Bing, and other mainstream search engines. The second service out there is StartPage, which works a bit differently from DuckDuckGo. What StartPage does is they grab Google search results and they supply it to you through their own service, stopping Google from seeing the user behind the search. People typically call StartPage a Google proxy, since all they're doing is acting as a private middleman. Because you are getting Google results, you are going to have the best possible search experience using StartPage. Some of the downsides are, one, they aren't very popular, so setting this to work with your browser by default may prove to be a little bit more challenging, depending on the device and browser of your choice. And second, they don't offer an onion site for Tor users, so you'll have to connect to their normal website when you're using Tor. We'll talk about Tor in section 4. The last service is search.me. Apparently, the X can make a ch sound in some languages, so we're gonna go with that pronunciation. It's kind of a debated topic. It is commonly regarded to be the best search engine when it comes to your privacy. They are an open source meta search engine, meaning they get results from several search engines and bring them to you using their service. It privately grabs results like StartPage does with Google, but it offers a lot more services, as you can see here. It actually grabs results from DuckDuckGo and StartPage as well. So yeah, if you can go this route, I highly recommend search.me. The way they supply results is plain awesome. So those are the three big names when we're talking about privacy-oriented search engines. It's important to move your searches off of unprivate search engines to services that value your privacy. Once you pick the one you like, I'd recommend setting it as your default search engine and adding it to your omnibar search on the top of your browser, if that is an option in your browser. That's going to wrap this up. It's a fairly simple topic, and I hope it all made sense. The next four lessons are going to be a quadrilogy about browsers. There's so much information about proper browsing habits, so those will teach you everything you need to know. The first lesson is titled Your Browser. Until then, and thank you for watching.